Hello YouTubers. Okay, so this is a follow-up to the kind of DIY camera boom slash jig that I made. I had a few challenges I wanted to overcome, and I've kind of addressed those. I just wanted to post this video to show you that. Yeah, I have to excuse this footage. It's with another camera where there's no image stabilization, and I'm not 100% sure what the quality is going to turn out like. But anyway, we'll do as best we can. So one of the challenges was basically with that camera attached to the table, because it used to screw onto the table, it obviously used to pick up shake when I had something on the table, and with a macro zooming, it would be a nightmare. The other problem was with the articulation of the arm, I could only work in this area over here basically. I didn't have enough space to come back. So I realized I had to kind of put something together to get around both those problems. So basically, here's my solution. I realized I had to have the arm, the actual base, not connected to the table, but something independent of the table. So what I did was I put this arm together, and I've attached it with a gate hinge to this wall over here. Now, so just a few notes about this, what I'd call Heath Robinson gear. And again, if you haven't heard of Heath Robinson, go and look him up. Normally, it's not a very complimentary term if someone says, oh, that looks a bit Heath Robinson, but that's just the way I work sometimes. So I've got this gate hinge here. And the reason I chose the gate hinge was basically I can lift this whole thing off here if once I want it out the way. And I could actually put another gate hinge up somewhere else on the wall and actually have it hanging so it's all out the way. You'll note this, where I've mounted this, is actually not the best place, but it was where I had to mount it because I didn't have space on front of the wall. The bolts, although there's a lot of, I say bolts, these kind of screws which are holding the hinge on, are in shear. So in essence, the tension which is on them is pulling that way, which is their weakest point. So it's not the most ideal mounting, but I've been forced to do that. If you're gonna do this, ideally you want it so that your tension is this way, on so they're in tension basically, not in shear, but it works for me. So anyway, so I've got this thick piece of wood on here, and I've got these draw sliders with these roller bearing draw sliders, which I just kind of picked out at the hardware store. And the reason for that is basically having the camera mounted on here. If I want to come across this way, first of all, it needs to hinge out that way. So as you can see, it can move right out that way and give me that level of movement. But if I'm coming out this way, I may get to a point where I'm over here. If I've got, if I want to see something over here on the desk, the angle's gonna go wrong of the camera. It's gonna start pulling around that way. So the hinges basically allow this to pull out and extend the range, so when I pull the camera over here, I can have it square and be watching things over here. So anyway, I thought that was just a little addition to the whole camera boom idea. As you can see, it kind of all articulates and moves around. That means it's independent of my desk, so it's not going to pick up wobble, and just having the two motions of kind of being able to swing it out and back and forth. Now obviously you need to note that having this arm with the magnifying glass movement and the camera attached is a fair bit of weight. So there's a fair bit of twist in this wood. Hence these rails actually pull out, these rails can actually pull out, so you get just the thin rail, but then you're going to get a fair bit of flex because there's weight. So basically I'm setting this up so when I pull it out, I only pull with this the back rail there as well to give it a fair bit of stiffness, and I don't need to go too far. But anyway, it seems to work all right for me. I'll show you some camera footage from it in a further update. And there have been some good suggestions about lighting, but I am still gonna play and put a diffuser under here, a kind of white piece of Perspex, to see how well that works. Anyway, if you wish to continue watching, following this little project and how well it works out, then certainly do subscribe. If you gain any value from watching this video, then please give it a thumbs up. And I shall post an update shortly. Thanks very much for watching.